this is going to take forever, right? Or is it? No, it's not. It's not going to take forever at all. Scene edit detection. This is going to save your actual life. Today's topic is video editing for Instagram. Specifically, if you have a video that you have made for some other social network, how do you make it for Instagram? How do you do a re-edit or a recut, a reframe? If I wanted to make this square, the first thing I think people would do is they would right click, they would go to reveal sequence and project so that you find it here. Then you would duplicate it. So you can either go to right click duplicate, or you can just press alt and drag down to duplicate. And then I'm going to rename this square and then open that up. Obviously nothing's changed because it's just a duplicate, right? So I would go to sequence settings and change it to, you know, a square aspect ratio. So right now it's 1920 by 1080, 16 by 9, just like we talked about. I would do 1080 by 1080 and make it a square. So now it's 1 by 1, and I press okay. And it's like, are you sure? Because you have a bunch of rendered clips on this timeline, and making them square will make them unrendered. And I'm like, yeah, that's fine. I get it. So as you can see, that green line up top changed to yellow, because it was all rendered before. The thing that it's done essentially is it's taken all of those clips that are actually like this size, and it's just cut the middle out. If I go to effect controls motion, I can see the bounding box around it. And I can see that this is the actual size of the clip, and it is just cut out the center, right? But sometimes the action isn't in the center. Sometimes the point of interest is off center. Like here, I have this lady and she is with the umbrella and she's slightly off center, right? So I have to go into my motion controls. If I select the word motion, I can now move it side to side. Obviously it moves freely. So if I select hold down shift, then it just moves side to side and it's a little bit easier for me to reframe. Or I can literally hover my mouse over the position controls and reframe it that way. So instead of doing all that jazz, instead, let's just go back to the original one, 16 by 9, right? And we're going to right click, we're going to go to reveal sequence and project. So there it is in our little project there. And then we're just going to right click and go to auto reframe sequence. You guessed it. You guessed it, folks. Auto reframe. What do you think that does? It auto reframes it for us. So we're going to go to auto reframe sequence and it will literally ask us, how do you want to auto reframe it? What is your target aspect ratio? Do you want it to be square? Do you want it to be a vertical rectangle? Do you want it to be like full vertical? Or do you have like a custom thing in mind? Maybe, you know, you're auto reframing this for like a website banner or something. I'm going to say, let's do 4 by 5. And I'm just going to call it Toronto travel video chameleon, tall, square, auto reframed. And then it also asks you about the motion tracking. Now, this isn't telling you how it will track the motion. It's literally asking you the motion in your video. Is it fast or slow? Because that it wants to analyze it properly. So for example, if you have a lot of like action sports, you're going to want to select faster motion. If your entire video is filmed on tripods, you're going to want to select slower motion. I'm going to select default because I'm just going to let it do what it does. And then I'm going to press create. And bada bing, bada boom, that's it. That's it. It's done. There we go. So now it has gone ahead and auto reframed every single clip in my timeline to this new aspect ratio, which is pretty wild. Premiere has this captions workflow, this captions workspace. So if I go into the captions workspace and I just have this big old fat file here, there's options. There's transcribe sequence, create a new caption track, or import captions from file. So I have gone ahead and downloaded the caption track from YouTube. I'm going to say import captions from file. And it's right here, captions. It's in my documents folder. I'll open that up. And it asks me, what format do I want it? Do I want it as a subtitle? Yes. It asks me, what style do I want it? I'll say none for now. It'll just be the default style that Premiere has. And where do I want to start it? I want to start it at the timeline start, because that's how the caption track was generated, from the timeline start. And I'll say, okay. And there it is. Those are the subtitles right up here. They've been generated already. Now, and they've been broken up into their proper length, because that's how it was from the YouTube auto-generated subtitles. So let's take a look at these. So we'll select this one and we'll increase the size. That's a little too much. That's fine. Yep. Let's make it a bold. Let's give it a little bit of space. Kerning, letting. I know this is Behance. I know that you people know whether this is kerning or letting. I do have a degree in graphic design and I keep forgetting. That rhymed. Okay, so perfect. So now that I've applied it to that one, right, it hasn't applied to everything, but I can make a track style here. So right now it says none, but if I go to create style and I rename it, so I'm going to say big subtitle black box. Now it is a style, and now that style has been applied to every single one of the captions. Say I wanted to change the aspect ratio of this, right? Maybe I want to make it a square now. I'll go right click, reveal sequence and project, and take a look. Because I dragged my original clip, remember, this was my original clip, and I dragged it into new sequence. That sequence has appeared in my footage folder right next to it. That's what happens whenever you take a clip and drag it into a sequence. But I have my sequences folder here. So let me rename it first. And I'll say visual style 16 by 9. So I know. I'll drag it into sequences just to make sure that I'm all organized. I will right click. I'll go to auto reframe sequence. Let's say I want to make it a square, right? So instead of 16:9, 1 by 1, I'll say create. So there we go. And you can see that the subtitles have updated, right? They've updated to the size of the sequence. They're not like running past the edges. They are now still very much on screen. And if I want to now, I'm like, wow, that's pretty intense, the size of these subtitles. That's pretty crazy. How can I adjust that in a way that is not going to like look so wild? I'll just go ahead. I'll select any of these, right? Select it. And right now it says track style, big subtitle, black box, right? But I can change the size of the text. I can even, you know, I can even change the location a little bit, because I know that there's going to be like, I know I'm going to tag someone in this, and I know that that tag is going to appear here on the bottom left of the screen. It's going to block it. I know that here it's going to say something. I don't know what, but it's definitely going to say something. So I want to keep it a little higher. And you can see that now I can create a new style with that. So I'm going to say create style, smaller subs, higher. Okay. And now all the subs are smaller and higher. But here's the problem that happened. As I did this, this entire thing was just one big block, right? So it auto reframed the sequence, but the sequence only had one clip in it. So essentially, it just auto reframed the clip. And that's no bueno, because all it did was essentially still cut out the middle. So all of this stuff that like, maybe I'm not centered. I mean, I've been centered in a lot of it, but let's say that this one, for example, I'm not centered. It doesn't recognize it because it's not different cuts. So you would almost have to, let's go back to visual style 16:9. You would almost have to go back and go, okay, where is the cut? You'd have to go back to editing, right? let's hide the subtitles for now. You'd have to go back and say, oh, okay, where's the cut? There it is. So let's get my blade tool to C. Let's click C. Now I'm on my razor tool. Thank you. It's called razor tool, not blade tool. Valentina, what are you doing? Then I'll go right, 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 frame by frame. There's the cut. The cut is usually on the first frame of the next cut or of the next clip. That's where you place the cut. So here, okay, that's the cut, except now I have snapping on and it's snapping to the subtitles. So let me track lock that so it's not snapping. It's still snapping, whatever. Okay, then, okay, next cut is here. That's the next cut. Okay. Oh, that's the next cut there. Cut. Okay. This is going to take forever, right? Or is it? No, it's not. It's not going to take forever at all because all I have to do is right click it and go to scene edit detection. This is going to save your actual life. So I'm going to click scene edit detection and it's going to say, what do you want? And I'm going to say, please apply a cut at each detected cut point. Now, it's also going to say, do you want me to create a bin of sub clips from each cut point? Which is awesome, right? Because say that this is a string out and you want each clip by itself as a sub clip so that then you can like put them into other things. Totally a great way to do that. And then if you want markers at each cut point, you can also do that too. But for me, I just need this so that I can reframe it, right? So that each of those cut points creates a new little clip that then Premiere can go and say, oh, I know what this is. Let me auto reframe it. So I'm going to say analyze. It's going to take a hot second to do, but guess what? I already did it. So we can just go to that. Bada bing, bada boom. I hope you enjoyed this class today on like some tips and tricks that you could do for Instagram. I hope this makes your life a lot easier. Happy editing, and I'll see you later. Bye, everybody.